Where do you see yourself 5 years from now? I have no idea. I always say this, but I never try to like plan things out too much or to a T, because things normally don't go your way. And the second you have expectations is when you open yourself up to be really disappointed. But in 5 years, hopefully I will have my own place. I'll still be traveling. Hopefully the channel will be taken off and maybe it could be my full career, but we'll see. What would you choose, bag or shoes? I'd have to go with shoes, because I think when you have a really nice pair of shoes on, actually that's hard though, because sometimes I like wearing sneakers with a nice bag, but when you have a really nice pair of shoes on, it can bring together any outfit and you can tell a lot by someone's shoes. What is the best and worst purchases you've ever made? All right, so if Sid Hag is watching this, she's gonna laugh, because we were just FaceTiming about this. I just bought a gown for like $200 and I have nowhere to wear it. I just kind of wanted to buy it, like it made no sense. And I think my best purchase was probably the vlogging camera, because it really opened up this new outlet of creativity and it has been a lot of fun. What was by far your favorite vacation spot or place so far, and why? Recommend. So I think there's a difference between traveling and vacation. I've spoke about this before, but if you are looking for a vacation where you're just gonna chill or even hike, I would recommend Hawaii. It is incredible. Some of the most beautiful scenery, everything I've seen. It's just one of the most beautiful places I've ever been. If you're looking for traveling and seeing things that are like super out of your comfort zone, for me that was Asia and the Philippines, but also Peru. Peru was unlike anything I think I've ever seen before, with Rainbow Mountain and the salt mine, and it's also one of my most recent trips, so I know I always tend to favor the ones I was just on because it's most fresh in my mind. But honestly, I recommend everywhere and anywhere, because you can really learn things no matter where you go. One thing, I do recommend going places that maybe not like everybody else has gone. Like, actually, I take that back. Go anywhere you want. Who'd win in a fight and why? A grilled cheese sandwich or a taco? That's so difficult for me. But a grilled cheese sandwich, I think, because while it's super classic and basic, it doesn't get better than like butter and cheese. Favorite memory from childhood has to be the vacations to Martha's Vineyard as an entire family. I know we have some video somewhere of that and I need to find it, but we used to, all five of us, go to Martha's Vineyard, and my Nona and Nona would come too, and we would spend 2 weeks in the summer bike riding and swimming and eating ice cream and just all the good stuff. When was the last time you cried? Probably last week. I'm pretty much a crybaby, so it can happen like really easily. Best thing about YouTube, getting to know you guys. Honestly, having conversations with people that I never would have ever even crossed paths with without it, that is amazing. And another thing I think is one of the best things about YouTube, although you said one, I also think just being able to look back and have this record of these like video logs of my life is like, I love rewatching old vlogs. So, can you make a video on how to be outgoing, life of the party, make friends, and be confident? I really can't, because I think that's something that you work on yourself. I mean, I think for me, maybe I was always outgoing, but you really need to be like fully content with yourself. And then in social situations, you're kind of just, you can be outgoing and you can be loud or however you want to be, because you're super comfortable with yourself, so you don't mind putting yourself out there. I think a good way to do that is just spend alone time. I spend a lot of time alone, and you just get to know yourself and know what you like, what you don't like what you enjoy doing, when you're most comfortable, what makes you uncomfortable. So really like spend time with yourself and figure out what you think your strengths are, and then you can play on those. What is your favorite restaurant in the USA? That is hard. That is, it depends like where you are. Basically, if you go to landtable.com and go to food, you'll find a ton. But one I'm thinking of right now is the one that Kevin and I always go to, Taste of Greece. It's a teeny, teeny one in a really small town. And it has the best like tzatziki, grilled octopus, which I could kill for right now. What inspired you to become a travel vlogger? Was it easy when you started? Any advice? What inspired me was, I remember watching Casey Neistat and thinking he was amazing, and I really just wanted to remember things, because like I said, when we would go away with our family, I almost don't like, we have photos, but I don't remember exactly what happened. So when I started going on trips that I was paying for, I was like, I want to remember every single thing, and I want to be able to look back on it and remember everything I did. So the love of having those memories kind of is what has inspired me. Advice, just start. I started with my phone, camera, yeah. Just start recording them. Even if it's just for yourself, it's the best. What's your favorite souvenir that you have? Definitely my rings. This one's from Arizona, the Arizona road trip with Gabby and Amanda. This is from Peru. These two are from Peru. This one is from Italy. This is from Outer Banks. This is from India. India, Outer Banks. This is from home. These are from India. But yeah, I think my rings, because I just love collecting rings. Those have been my favorite. Why is Shane not vlogging anymore? That is a great question. You'd have to ask him. I think he's just super busy with lacrosse. What two things do you love about Kev? He is so patient with me, and I can be a hell of a lot to handle, as you guys know. And also, he's just super sweet. He's kind to everybody. Like, everybody. I love that. Can I be in your Q&A? Sure. Hope you're doing well. What's your favorite cuisine, and what have you yet to try? My favorite cuisine, I think, is Mediterranean food in like any way, shape, or form. I've yet to try, I'm trying to think. There are a lot of things I haven't tried yet that I would love to try. Name your favorite sports team, starting with baseball, basketball, football, then hockey. Baseball, Yankees. Basketball, I don't really watch. Football, Giants, which I don't really watch. And then hockey, Rangers, 100% Rangers. Hockey is my favorite. What's your favorite country that you've been to so far? That is impossible to answer for so many reasons. Thank you guys so much for sending me questions, and let me know if you like Q&As, if you want some more. I love filming them, but maybe you guys don't love sit down videos as much. Just let me know in the comments and give it a thumbs up if you do like these types of videos, and I will see you in my next video. Oh, why didn't I have it on really bright?
No one cares.